When Worlds Collide 1951 take about a trillion. Jesus. Anyways, so they find out that there's a star with a planet around it hurtling toward the Earth, and it's going to destroy us, kill us dead, right? So they hurriedly build this spaceship, an ark, like Noah's Ark, but a big spaceship instead, to save humanity, well, select few of humanity, and take them to planet Zeta. So, of course, it all goes wrong. There's disasters, there's all kinds of, floods, earthquakes, lava, a rebellion. Yeah, your typical 1950s sci-fi movie. You betcha. It's really badly acted, really badly written, but really fun to watch. 6 out of 10. Beyond the Time Barrier, 1960. So, dude's testing really, really fast aircraft that is hypersonic and goes very, very high in the atmosphere, near orbit type, or near, I forget what it's called, near outer space, anyways, in the last part of the atmosphere. And as he goes really, really fast, like 6,000 miles an hour, he breaks the time barrier and ends up in 2024. 2 years from now, right? Anyways, and he finds that the base is, when he lands on it, the base is destroyed and all this. He goes toward this light, finds out that there's this fantastic city sitting there, and he gets zapped with a stun ray and interrogated by the people who think he's either working for another government or something like that, or one of the mutants, or all this blah blah blah. Anyways, typical 1960s, 50s and 60s sci-fi movie, yet again. Poorly acted, poorly written, but really fun to watch. Yeah, I'm going to give this one a 6 out of 10 as well. The 27th Day, 1957. So these five people from five different countries around the world that are pretty much at odds with each other are given the power to destroy the world or just their enemies. It's a pretty good one, actually. They get 27 days to decide what to do. And if on the 27th day at midnight they do not use the weapons, they will become inactive. The aliens want to colonize Earth, but they don't want to kill anyone to do it. So this is their thing. And to make it harder for make the decision more political, they broadcast to the entire planet who these people are. And of course, the obvious happens with that, right? They're encouraged to use them. Anyways, long story short, there's a twist near the end where something happens with one of the holders of the capsules. He does something incredibly profound, and it raises a really big ethical dilemma with my brain. I'm not going to tell you what it is because that would spoil it. Anyways, this is pretty darn good for a B-rate movie. I'm going to give it a 7 out of 10.